welcome to the live stream video interviews here at Alfred's on Beale Street. We are from the National Women in Blues, and thanks to Yippee Radio, we are going live video stream for you today. First, let me introduce your host
for the day. Come here, Miss Erica.
Hello.
This is Erica Brown, an incredible blues woman. She also came in last year to help host our live streams. It turned out the woman's got a knack, not only as a performer and singer, but a knack for hosting and asking questions and keeping people engaged. So
I think, got a big mouth.
Well, I know, and it's a perfect though. It's a perfect big mouth. So I asked her to come back. So we'll come back for you next, Erica.
Patti Parks.
Hey,
Patti! Patti Parks, come on deck, sweet one.
Oh, look at you. I'm going home.
You're going.
I'm going home. I'm going to roll you in the alley for that shirt.
Now, you make sure not just to talk about your music, but you talk to her about nursing the blues.
I know. Right? Yes.
All
yes,
right.
Absolutely.
As a matter of
fact. Hello.
Hello. How are you, sweetheart? You got no C, right?
I know, right? We got to stop meeting like this.
Yeah, yeah.
Sit down. So, okay. So, you guys, this is Patti Parks. Yes, right? Right? Extraordinaire. I'm going to start from the top from what Michelle actually talked about. You are on a symposium tomorrow. Is it tomorrow or Friday?
It's Friday.
Friday.
It's Friday.
Called Blues as Healer.
Yes.
Please tell me about it.
Well, first of all, I got this call from the Blues Foundation that said, you know what, there's something going on, but I think you might be interested.
Okay.
And Marie Trout, Dr. Marie Trout,
yes.
Walter Trout's wife,
yes,
has recently written a book about that subject.
Okay.
My piece of this, I've got a program that started about 2 years ago that uses a new genre.
Okay.
For chemical dependency.
Okay.
Started with girls at about 16 years old in a campus for about 18 months. So we developed a plan for which they use both music history, along with making a correlation of what was going on.
Yes.
And also, so there's a connection with the lyrics, but they also engage into a therapeutic program. So there's a science behind it.
Yes.
And because I'm a nurse, I call it nursing the blues.
So that's what I'm talking about.
Yes, yes. So I'll be joining them on Friday to discuss our application of the very thing that Dr. Marie Trout found is there's some, you know, physiological changes in the body when you listen to blues music.
Uh-huh.
And I'm going to test to that.
Amen.
All right. Wow, that is it's wonderful. I mean, like we talk about this thing that we do, that we love, that is who we are, called blues. But there's so much more. I mean, it affects you on every level: physical, spiritual, mental, psychological, physiological.
Yeah.
And I always say it gets you where you live.
Yeah. Some people call it your own church, whatever that is.
Right? Absolutely, absolutely.
So, and I think that what's really grand about this is that Dr. Trout also got some evidence. It didn't matter just so much about, you know, a lot of times we think about the application of hurting souls. But this was to a general population.
Yes.
It's effective in a very positive way.
Yeah, yeah.
So I know for myself, it made a lot of changes.
Yeah. Now, I know you are also an active musician. Do you have a project out right now?
Actually, I'm back doing our CD.
Okay.
You know, but just recently I was at Art Studios and I did a song with one of the gentlemen here, which is very exciting.
Uh-huh.
Recently I've been inducted in the Hall of Fame where I live, so I'm very excited.
Look at
about
you.
That. So it's been one of those years, you know what I mean?
Oh, yes, I do.
So you just pay attention to those cues and you just go with it.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yes. Wow. I saw you last night in the Rum Boogie and
yay!
I should say that about you, girl. It's unbelievable. Oh my
gosh. So much fun. But that's part of what happens on Beale Street during this particular time of year in the International Blues Challenge. Now, tomorrow is the Women Blues Showcase. And are you going to be able to come back?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I will. Awesome. You know, I participated the last 2 years prior.
Yes. So I introduced you last year.
Yes, you did. So
that's right.
It's my year to relax and enjoy all the wonderful time that's going to be there.
Yes, indeed. It is going to be absolutely amazing. And that's part of what we're doing today. You know, we're interviewing the ladies who are going to be an integral part of what's going on. But I really wanted to touch on the Blues and Healer Symposium on Friday, because that is something that is kind of changing the face of how blues is perceived. You know, it's not just the music you sit down and listen to and drink.
It's something that, you know, just was a grand idea and dropped. It just like propelled to a point of which people are really looking at and saying, how can we use this in a way?
Yes.
And again, it's not just it's great therapeutic to see a lot of what's different about it is there's the plan, and it was a plan that's developed.
Yeah.
And it serves like an adjunct therapy to wellness.
Yeah.
So the body, spirit, and mind is wellness. Because otherwise, we don't go anywhere without that.
Right. All right. Oh, my goodness. I'm just loving it. All right. Okay. So I get to ask you a question on the list.
Okay.
Name, if you can, you ask tough questions, Michelle. Name your favorite male and female blues artists. Do you know who those are? Or is it a group? Or is it a group of people? Or is it?
Oh, my favorite.
That's
you're right. That is tough.
That's a hard question.
Yeah, that is tough. Well, I'll tell you something. My female, so there's so many of them, so that's going to be really hard. I don't even really want to answer that. Let me say this too. I listen to all different types of male artists for different reasons.
Yeah.
Because everybody has a different thing they bring to the table.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes I like to listen to different takes on certain types of music within the blues genre. So whether it's gospel blues or whether it's swing blues, I've got my favorites of all of those elements.
Yeah.
So I'm going to defer that right now because that's how I feel.
All right.
And that's, you know what, that doesn't go very far from male artists as well.
Yeah.
Okay, because you know I love rock blues, I love gospel.
Yeah, yeah.
And so I'm still opening my doors to hearing and receiving all that stuff.
Yeah.
So I can't even say.
You're right.
That was a tough question.
It's a tough question.
But I'm not running away. It's the truth.
It's all right.
It's the truth.
People ask me all the time, you know, what's your favorite song? What's your favorite song? And my answer always knocks everybody for a loop because it's so not what people think I'm going to say. It is. Where the Boys Are by Connie Francis. It is the most perfectly sung song I have ever heard. Take that song, break it down, and just listen to what she does within that song. I have no words. Seriously, it's unbelievable. I know it's like way over there somewhere.
It's okay.
You know,
okay.
But of course, you know, there are my foundations. You know.
But they're connected.
Absolutely. It got me where I live. And that's, you know, that whole movie where Boys Are, it's like kind of an old movie.
Oh,
here she goes. You know I will.
I know you will.
Go ahead.
Where
the boys are.
Oh, baby, I can't so touch that.
Waits for me. Yo, Katie, I had it. Wait a minute. See now, all right, Miss Thing, I'm gonna put you back on the spot.
Uh-oh, here we go.
Go ahead, give me some. Give me.
Oh, let me think now. Now you're scaring me right now. Oh, you're killing me.
But this is why we're blues women, y'all. Yeah. This is what we do.
Well, let me say this too. Yeah. I made up a song.
Go ahead.
I'm just making up right now.
Go ahead.
You know,
I'm
okay. You know what, Eva?
Uh-huh.
There have been times in my life.
Yes.
Where I've never been as happy as I am today.
Preach
this. Cause you know who I am. Cause I met you this moment. This moment in time. Lord knows I got it all together. Cause it's just you. And that's it.
Oh my goodness. Yeah. That is what I am talking about. Oh my goodness. You know, when we labor away at this thing that we do, that we love, you know, this thing called the blues.
Yeah.
But there are so many other things that have shaped us and made us the blues women that we are.
Yeah.
You know, our life experiences, our romantic experiences, our physical experiences, you know, the psychological things that put you in a particular headspace.
Right.
And then all of a sudden, you wake up out of a sound sleep and you're writing a song, you know.
Okay.
You know, kind of people that keep a pencil and a pad
yeah.
by the side of your bed because all of a sudden it's like, oh, I gotta write that down before I forget
right.
it,
right.
you know.
Right.
And next thing you know, you've got a song. What, you know, it's absolutely amazing.
That's so cool. You know, your connection.
Yes.
The connection. Right?
Very much. Very much.
And like you said, it's through lived experience.
Yes.
And agree.
Yes. And now, do you have a website?
I do.
Okay.
The Patti Parks Band.
ThePattiParksBand.com?
.com.
Excellent. Excellent. I know we can go on there and find out all about you. You guys go on and find all out about that. I can't get over that shirt.
I know. Don't think you're going to take it. Now.
Dang. Well, I can't because you're this adorable size that I was when I was. Listen, I'm still trying to lose the 20 pounds I gained when I was pregnant 39 years ago. So I kind of, you know, I'm trying not to think
wait,
about
it. Wait, does that mean I can go get burger?
Yes, you can.
Oh, wait a minute. Can I go get some ribs?
And have them for me. And a fried pie and
there
some ice
go.
Cream.
All right, I'm going.
All right. Thank you so
Thank
much.
Thank you so much.
Girl.
Oh.